afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is Tuesday, and we have more from Bonnie Duquette today. She's going to be talking about how to organize your refrigerator and basically how to put things into place so you cannot fail when it comes to eating healthy. Check it out.
Great. Let's move out of the kitchen and let's talk about some other tips that you have.
And one of the things I suggest that everybody do, regardless of, how busy you are or you don't think you are, is to investigate and potentially utilize a food delivery service to ensure that you have food in the house, your food is fresh, and it's applicable to your meals. Because we've all gotten to that point where we look in the fridge and there's no good leftovers and there's just no fresh food. And instead of, whipping something up, at that point most of us give in and say, you know what, I'll call for pizza, and you make a bad decision. Even worse, if you're running home from work and you don't have anything healthy on you, you're more likely to drive through the dreaded drive-thru. So really giving yourself the time and the planning necessary is really one of the biggest tools for healthy eating. And one of the biggest things I suggest for absolutely everybody is to plan. Sit down at the beginning of the week or the beginning of the month, depending what works for you, and write down the meals you're going to have every night. And that doesn't have to be that specific. One night could be leftovers, and on that night you eat all the leftovers you have in the fridge. You could write down, crock pot meal, and then you're going to cook something in the crock pot. However, then investigate your recipes, and I always suggest that you keep, extra recipes on hand that you use often. And what I mean by that is everybody has dozens and dozens of cookbooks, and there may be one recipe you like in each one of those cookbooks. But I suggest put those into a binder, and this is what we do personally, is I have them all in the binder, and then when I sit down to do my meal planning at the beginning of the week, I kind of go through and say, what looks good to me this week? Now, you can do that more scientifically. Some people like to rotate them on a numerical basis. I'm more of a feeling eater. I like to say, what do I feel like this week? So if we're in for a snowstorm, I might make a stew. This week we're having some great weather here in the Northeast, so I was going for some more Mexican tropical fare, trying to urge the weather on with what I'm eating.
Right.
But involve your family members. Ask the kids, what do they like to eat? And you'll be surprised with their answers. What you think might be their favorite meal might not be their favorite meal at all. And one of the things you can do is ask them to pick a meal that they will either make for the family or assist you in making, depending upon their age and their skill set. And a lot of times kids will take a lot of pride in that one meal and, really look forward to making it either with you or showing it for the family.
How much more does like one of these delivery services cost? I've never used one. Have you used one, and kind of is it that much more expensive?
Normally they only charge, depends on the amount you purchase at one point in time. I've used them from time to time when life has gotten super chaotic and I know that I'm not going to get to the grocery store. But normally if you purchase $50 or more, it's only a $5 charge, which to me, a lot of people say, well, I can't afford $5. But those same people will go through the drive-thru when they're hungry or when they're out of food at home. And that's going to cost you more than $5. So, in my opinion, is the $5 worth having healthy food for your family in the house and avoiding going out to eat? Absolutely.
We recently were at a house in New Jersey with a family. We're helping them organize some of their refrigerator and their cabinets and some of the where their food was. And we pulled some things out of the freezer that, they must have been 3 or 4 years old. And so I know that you probably, I'm sure you have some sort of system for buying bulk, organizing. So can you please explain that? Because I'm a feeling that they and everyone else would probably, want to know, how they can avoid having this stuff in the freezer for years maybe.
Absolutely. And, the freezer is one of the greatest tools we have for eating healthy, is that it allows us to store those home-cooked meals over a long period of time. So there's a few different things I like to do for the freezer. First of all, if you are buying in bulk, invest in really great freezer bags or invest in a sealing system such as Food Saver, and those allow you to get all of the air out and then freeze it. The second thing is have Sharpies on the side of your fridge, on the top of your fridge, so that every single item that goes into that freezer gets labeled with what it is, And people always say, well, that's obvious. And I say, well, once it's frozen and it's been in there for 6 months, it might not be so obvious. So just humor me and label it now. And also label it with the date you cooked it and put it into the freezer. And again, that's going to give you an automatic expiration date, just like you'd have on a can of soup in your pantry. Then once you put an item into the freezer, I suggest having a freezer contents list on the side of your fridge. We actually have one available for free on our website. You can download and print it off and just write down what's in your freezer. Now, don't go too crazy with it. You know, if you have bread in your freezer, you might just write down bread. You know, you don't need to write, 2 pounds of green beans. You can just write green beans. And then
I just wanted to say, where can someone find that before we forget?
That is on www.thejoyfulorganizer.com, and you'll be able to find that under our freebies. You can download that and print it out all you want.
Cool.
And one of the things people don't think of in their freezer is storage containers. You know, buy some really inexpensive 99-cent plastic containers from Walmart, Target. Put them inside your freezer. They're not going to get hurt. The worst-case scenario is they're going to get a little dirty. And what I suggest doing is, depending upon the setup of your freezer, making one of these containers small lunchable items. So if you have frozen meals or frozen chicken breasts or things that are small and that you would eat for lunch, put those in one bin. And then if you have desserts such as popsicles or yogurt pops or frozen bananas, put those in another bin. And then finally have one for fruits, vegetables, smoothie making items, and then you can have one for frozen meats. And not only is this going to help you keep an inventory, it's going to, again, help you have a visual list of what you have. And it's going to help you eat better because when you go into the fridge, when you go into the freezer, I know the first thing I have is a big basket of frozen fruit and frozen veggies to make smoothies with. So, you know, if I'm standing in the kitchen hungry and, you know, we all have craving or whatnot, I open that up and I'm like, you know what, I should have something healthy right now. So it's a visual reminder to me to not hit the junk food, hit something healthy instead.
Your question of the day is this, yes or no, does your refrigerator, your freezer look as organized as Bonnie explains? I want to know. Post it down below. Tell us the truth. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.